If you're somebody who's been told that you need to lose 20 or 30 kilograms, and if you want to improve your diabetes, you need to completely change your exercise and activity levels, you may not have been told what you need to know. And if you watch this short video, it will all become clear.
I just wanted to spend a little bit of time explaining this concept of the body mass index and the ideal body weight, so that you better understand how achievable really quite significant success is. So the first thing is about body mass index, BMI, and simply it is a measure of your weight in kilograms divided by your height in meters. And for mathematical reasons, they square the height. So if I weighed 60 kilos and I was 1.5 meters in height, then it would be 60 kilograms over 1.5 times 1.5. And that would give me my BMI. And the normal reference range, or the normal range, what we call the normal range, is based on clinical studies that tracked the risk of somebody developing a complication and compared the risk to the body mass index. And if I draw this, this is what we call a J-shaped curve. Because actually, if you're too thin, it's not good. People who are very thin often have higher rates of risk of developing problems. And then as the weight goes up, there's an exponential increase in risk that occurs as your BMI goes up. But there's a little spot right down the bottom where the risk is at its lowest, and that is how we define the normal reference range. And for most people, that's between 20 and 25. And so that's when we talk about ideal body weight, it's ideal because it has the lowest rate of risk for things going wrong. So we think that's the most positive place to be. But what happens to people who are significantly overweight? Perhaps their BMI is 30, so that's the definition of obese, or 35 or 40. And if you start to plot that group of people, you can see that the risks become incredibly high for certain people. And the higher your body mass index is, the greater the risk. So people, for example, with a BMI of 40 have a risk that's really incredibly challenging. But the other interesting thing is that if you can reduce your body mass index from, say, 40 down to 35, that is a substantial risk reduction. And if you can reduce it from 35 down to 30, that's still a substantial risk reduction, but not as big as the person that has reduced their weight from a BMI of 40 down to 35. And if you go from 30 to 25, again, there's further risk reduction, but it's not as substantial. So whilst we talk to people about their ideal body weight, and if they weigh 100 kilograms, perhaps their ideal body weight might be 70. In fact, changing from 100 down to 90 has a profound effect because a person literally slides down the BMI curve, and in doing so has a massive risk reduction. So the trick with weight loss is not to think about what your ideal body weight is, because that actually may be very difficult to achieve, particularly if you're 30, 40, 50 kilos above what you should be. The trick with weight reduction is to understand the benefits that you get by making small, modest changes. And just if we look at something like diabetes, if a person is able to lose about 10% of their body weight, so if you weigh 110 kilos, then you're looking at 11 kilograms, that has a profound impact on how well your insulin works, on your glucose control, on your cholesterol, on your blood pressure. It's not about achieving perfection. It's about reducing risk as quickly and as effectively as possible in the most achievable way.